How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today we're going to be taking a look at ProtonVPN and NordVPN. Some of you guys have been asking, hey, which one is better? Well, it depends on what you're looking for at the end of the day. I personally think that ProtonVPN is a little bit more expensive for, I'm not sure what the reason is. I don't know why it's that expensive. It is more expensive than NordVPN and it doesn't perform as well. Now, does that mean that ProtonVPN is a bad VPN? No, it's actually one of the most trustworthy VPNs in the industry. It's independently audited. There are plenty of independent audit reports to show that they do uphold the privacy policy and they have a solid server infrastructure and all of their applications are open sourced and you can see the source code on GitHub and it's available for everybody to read, which is just absolutely fantastic. It's, you know, probably one of the only free VPNs out there that don't sell your data for marketing and advertising purposes. And that definitely explains why their free servers are always so congested, because it's such a popular free VPN that everybody just uses it. All right. Now, you do have pretty cool features here. Even with the free version, you get split tunneling, all the DNS and IPv6 leak protection in connection here. You do get a WireGuard protocol. And you do have, if we go here, so you have the secure core servers, which are only available, by the way, on the premium version. It's just going to give you more secure servers, only available to paid customers, of course. With NetShield, that is just the ad blocker, not available on the free version. And you have the kill switch, which is available on the free version, just like split tunneling and the selection of protocols, which is pretty generous of ProtonVPN. Now, if we're going to compare ProtonVPN to NordVPN, this is where almost not fair, because NordVPN performs so well that it completely overshadows even the paid version of ProtonVPN. Now, that's not to say that ProtonVPN, again, is a bad VPN. It's not. It's one of the best VPNs you can get in the industry. It's just that NordVPN is a few steps above ProtonVPN. First of all, you have the NordLynx protocol. It's a true WireGuard protocol, making NordVPN arguably the fastest VPN in the industry. You have specialty servers. You have over 5,400 servers in 60 countries. Whereas with ProtonVPN, you only have over 1,700 servers in 63 countries. So three more countries, but about over 3,500 servers less than NordVPN. Okay, and of course, if we go to the settings here, in my opinion, the user interface is much nicer. I love the map design of ProtonVPN. It's pretty cool, but I do prefer the design of NordVPN. I only wish that NordVPN's Windows application had a dark mode. Only the Mac application and Windows and iOS applications of NordVPN have a dark mode, but for some reason, the Windows version still doesn't have a dark mode. So that would be my only gripe with the NordVPN user interface. But overall, the kill switch is there. You have also an app kill switch, split tunneling, custom DNS, obfuscated servers. Oh, by the way, I believe ProtonVPN does have custom DNS. So right here, yeah. So you can set up your own custom DNS. So that's pretty cool. Yeah. ProtonVPN is definitely a well-rounded VPN in terms of features. But that's not all there is to it with NordVPN. Previously, NordVPN had an ad blocker feature right here, but they removed that and they integrated it into something called threat protection, which will block malware-ridden websites, stop web tracking, avoid malicious ads, and it will protect your device from infected files before you download them, which is great. And recently they added another feature, which is called MeshNet, which will allow you to share files over encrypted connections safely with your coworkers. So NordVPN is just coming across as such a well-rounded VPN, even, you know, for those in companies, for example, for those that want to share private files, they don't want to share them over the internet, they want to share them over some kind of encrypted connection, MeshNet will make for a great service or feature, all right? So overall, which is the best, which is better than the other? Depends on what you're looking for. I personally think NordVPN, if you're looking for a free VPN and you just want to secure your traffic on public Wi-Fi, ProtonVPN will do the job. With the free version though, even with the paid version, I don't really use ProtonVPN. I had a subscription with ProtonVPN. They're not exactly the best at unblocking streaming services. So this is why I would definitely choose NordVPN over ProtonVPN, because typically when I use a VPN, it's either to secure my device over on public Wi-Fi or unblock streaming services. And for that reason, I choose NordVPN. But it's up to you guys. If you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews that'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features of each one of these VPNs. All right, hopefully that gave you a bit of an idea so that you can choose between these two. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.